won the first ball. Eight minutes and 40 seconds, and Lou Thesz has taken the first fall in his title match with Wild Bill Longson. 8 minutes and 40 seconds, and Lou Thesz is the winner in this first fall with a flying body scissor and takedown. Top press for the count of three by referee Ray Gunkel. Now, here we go again for the second fall of this World Championship match. Wild Bill Longson, faced with the necessity of winning this second fall if he's going to stay in contention. Thesz won the first fall in 8 minutes and 40 seconds with that flying body scissor takedown, top press. Longson has started the maneuver which he's used with great success over the years. An effort to cripple either arm that the opponent sticks out there. The opponent sticks out an arm. Longson comes down with a hatchet chop across it with his own forearm. Now he's working on that same left arm with a bar. Oh. Mr. Thesz is after Longson's temper, and I think it's coming up. That's as fast a switch from a defensive maneuver to a rolling leg lock as we've ever seen. Longson manages to get his shoulders under the ropes, and so have the hold broken. Longson has apparently untied the shoelaces from one of Thesz's shoes and is gouging with that metal tip into Lou's legs. Longson spread eagle now in a split. You can see that Thesz has Longson's right leg tied out there with both wrists. Week in and week out at the Sportatorium in Dallas, you'll see the world's greatest wrestling matches. Or wrestling, as we refer to it. A certain amount of wrestling and a great amount of wrestling. This is an inside step-over toe hold used by Longson. You know, Lou Thesz won that first fall in 8 minutes and 40 seconds with the flying body scissor takedown. Now Longson is attempting to come back and keep his title chances alive by taking the second fall to even the match. And this Longson is a slick one. He can get by with probably more than any other wrestler. Once too many. You got caught that time, Mr. Longson. Gone by in our second fall, according to the official timekeeper. The going's too hot for Brother Longson. Jumping all the way down to floor level. He gets a few moments' respite here, and he starts back up only to be drop-kicked off the apron of the ring. Same thing again. Longson knocked down, but Fez partially missed that drop kick. He landed with only 1 foot. And when he came down against the canvas, it was on his right shoulder and the back of his head. Longson was not seriously hurt when he was knocked off the ring. Oh, there's that pile driver of Longson's, one of the most terrific holds he has. And he lifts Lou Fez, is not willing to let him be pinned. And he's going to put that pile driver on Fez again, dropping Fez on the top of his head. Covers him, one, and two, and three, and Wild Bill Longson has won the second fall. Six minutes and 58 seconds. And Longson evens the match. Two great wrestlers are Even Steven with a horse apiece going into the third and deciding fall now, this world's title match. Wild Bill Longson won that second fall in 6 minutes and 58 seconds with his famous pile driver slam. And from the way he's working that reverse chin, Locke, it looks like he's going to try to make a short knife. No, that pile driver didn't work that time. A flying drop kick and a second one. Fez apparently is staking all of his chances on a fast start in this third fall. And a fast finish, the count of three by referee Ray Gunkel. And Lou Fez has successfully defended his world's heavyweight championship by winning the third and deciding fall in only 2 minutes and 49 seconds. Lou Fez, apparently with an injured ankle, realizing that he had to stake everything on one fast and furious effort, wins the third and deciding fall in 2 minutes and 49 seconds for the series of flying drop kicks in the top press. So Lou Fez of St. Louis, Missouri is still the world's heavyweight championship after successfully defending his title in tonight's match at the Sportatorium against Wild Bill Longson. Promoter Ed McLemore and I hope that you've enjoyed it. Join us again.